Scanning the exhibition area. Module head found. Establishing coordinates. Assessing structural integrity. Head location.
Shit, it's dark here. I got a bad feeling.
Investors asked Soviet specialists to build another underwater city on the Saving data.
Crispy fucking. Where's the shit ass way out of here? Underground or something? Fuck me. Where am I supposed to find the head?
You need to enter Icarus Hall. It is located on the second story of this venue.
So where's the entrance?
Unfortunately, I do not have this information. Everything's got mixed up after the...
No shit, Sherlock.
Have you considered powering the Beluga?
How's that supposed to help?
I don't know. It's just a suggestion.
Well, I guess it can't hurt to try. It's not like we've got a lot of other options. Tereshkova, where's the power room around here?
At the very top!
Fantastic. So we're cut off. Just what I always wanted.
The Beluga is the world's fastest multi-purpose submersible vehicle. It can reach speeds of up to 78 kilometers per hour and is able to carry out civilian and military missions at depths down to 3,000 meters.
We've learned more about the ocean floor over the last few years than we had during the previous...
Let's not get into this right now, okay?
Thank you.
The Beluga is the world's fastest multi-purpose submersible vehicle. It can reach speeds of up to 78 kilometers per hour and is able to carry out civilian and military missions at depths down to 3,000 meters. The Beluga is the world's fastest multi-purpose submersible vehicle. It can reach speeds of up to 78 kilometers per hour and is able to carry out civilian and military missions at depths down to 3,000 meters.
Charles, so after the whole beta connector idea was dead, they made the neuro connectors with discretionary authority?
I'm afraid so. The power struggle in the Kremlin will never end. The party elite insisted on having power even within Collective.
Well, they're our government, right? We're the USSR.
Indeed we are. But Collective was designed to be for everyone on Earth, and the USSR is not the only country.
We can't let capitalists and imperialists into Collective.
Why not? Collective was designed as a worldwide union for equal human beings, where robots will do everything for them. Everyone will have the same opportunities.
The capitalists won't like the sound of that.
Unfortunately, no one in power will see equality as an appealing prospect. So to avoid being crushed by the Kremlin, Dr. Sechenov programmed discretionary authority into Collective.
I see. So where's the very top?
Thank you. mad!
This is where the power comes from.
Are you sure?
Definitely.
How?
Because this place has my favorite thing in the whole fucking world. A relay.
Really? I thought you were more partial to canisters.
Oh, come on.
Thank you.
Comrade Stockhausen, I took that foreign journalist for the secret tour of the BDNH. He saw everything. You should have seen his eyes bugging out of his head. They're going to be dying of envy when his article comes out. They'll slap more sanctions on us and order an extra bunch of bots. Those capitalists sure are a weird bunch, huh?
Charles, you think Volatova was in cahoots with Petrov because of more than just love, right? What makes you so sure?
I should note that Larissa Volatova is an accomplished and talented scientist. She independently completed a project that most of the world's greatest scientific minds could not have accomplished.
What's your point?
She is far from stupid, and would never blindly follow orders without serious justification, no matter who might be giving them.
Are you trying to say that good people are turning on the boss, and he's getting rid of them? So Petrov's actually a nice guy?
People whom the motherland has given everything must have serious reasons for betraying her. But the bloody path Petrov has chosen is unacceptable.
A capitalist collaborator. Fuck him.
I could not agree more.
Thank you.
here, you little fucker!
The Beluga is the world's fastest multi-purpose submersible vehicle. It can reach speeds of up to 70.
Let's see if this thing helps.
And is able to carry out civilian and military missions at depths down to 3,000 meters.
Oh yeah. Right. What do we have here? Tereshkova, do you copy?
Yes, dear comrade. The communication is restored.
So, where's that head of yours?
My head is where it's supposed to be, but Claire's head should be somewhere.
So, what will it be, Major? Weapons or abilities?
Looks like a maze for kids. This will be a cakewalk. Jumpy little thing, ain't ya? How do I rotate you, huh? Hey, I think I get it. Now we're getting somewhere.
Do you have any idea what you're doing, Major?
Just a sec.
Is it really that difficult?
Crispy goddamn fucking critters! Gotcha! Nice! Easy.
When warmth and beauty mingle, at the path's turn, a carcass lay asprawl upon a bed of shingle. Legs raised like some old whore, far gone in passion. The burning, deadly, poison, sweaty mass opened its pouch in careless, cynic fashion. Ballooned with evil gas. On this putrescence, the sun blazed in gold, cooking it to a turn with eager care. So to repay to nature hundredfold what she had mingled there, the sky, as on the opening of a flower, on the superb obscenity smiled bright. The stench drove at us with such fearsome power, you thought we'd swoon outright. Lies trumpeted upon the rotten belly, whence larvae poured in legions far and wide, and flowed like molten and liquescent jelly. Down living rags of hide, the mass ran down, or like a wave elated, rolled itself on and crackled as if crying. You'd think the corpse by vague breath animated. After multiplying through that strange world, a rustling rumor ran, like a rushing water or a gust of air.
Yes, found the head. We gotta keep moving. Charles, any idea how much time we got left?
I cannot say for sure. But definitely not much.
Gotcha.
Pride of Facility 3826. The floating platforms made in flight.
So, what was wrong with the real beta connectors?
Since Collective was originally planned without any discretionary authority, everyone in it was supposed to be equal.
Yeah, we already talked about that. Then why'd they need the beta connectors?
To secure Collective against unforeseen threats from individuals who might wish to control it.
That's impossible. Everybody's equal in Collective. Shit! The Alpha Connector!
Indeed. Intruders, or an opposition force among equals, could try to obtain the Alpha Connector. This could lead to human casualties, which would be unacceptable.
So, what was wrong with the real Beta Connectors?
Since Collective was originally planned without any discretionary authority, everyone in it was supposed to be equal.
Yeah, we already talked about that. Then why'd they need the Beta Connectors?
To secure Collective against unforeseen threats from individuals who might wish to control it.
That's impossible. Everybody's equal in Collective. Shit, the Alpha Connector.
Indeed. Intruders, or an opposition force among equals, could try to obtain the Alpha Connector. This could lead to human casualties, which would be unacceptable.
So how could Beta Connectors stop this from happening?
They didn't give their carriers any discretionary authority, but they did allow them to be present within Collective without being a part of it. In other words, they had total autonomy while retaining access to the information network.
So what? That's basically what we have right now.
You're seeing this from a human perspective.
What other kind of perspective could I... Aw, crap. Boss wanted to put Beta rings on some robots so no one else in Collective could control them.
Indeed, they are. At first, Dr. Sechenov planned to order his loyal teams to guard the Alpha Connector. While logged into Collective, he could control them from anywhere on Earth. At the same time, no one else would be able to give them orders. They wouldn't even know that they exist.
Hold on, Charles. I don't quite get it. Would it be possible to launch Collective with everybody equal, then destroy the Alpha Connector?
Certainly, but that begs another question. Who would choose to do that?
Dr. Sechenov.
Are you sure about that, Comrade Major?
Yeah, I mean, I guess.
Thank you. Don't worry, Dina. I'm actually glad they've got the Terrascovas giving tours now instead of us. We still get paid, and we get to take a nice vacation. Sounds good to me. My hubby and I are headed to Yalta to visit the family. I'm tired, you know? There are more and more tourists coming every day, even from Moscow. The adults ask question after question, and the kids? Ugh, they go nuts when they see all the gadgets here. Yesterday, two little boys almost fell into the polymer whale. Can you imagine? A lot of things fall into that whale, actually. Yevgeny, the janitor, says you can find all kinds of stuff in there.
Right. Installing the head.
22799100.
Hey, rise and shine. Good morning to
you. Thank you, dear comrade. Please be careful. There are aggressive robots everywhere.
Yeah, I noticed. What did you do to get dismembered?
I tried to rescue the living personnel of the exhibition complex.